Hey there, viewers! Are you loving these bright, sunny days? What's more awesome than spending the day outside? But one thing that manages to spoil the fun is a sunburn. Returning home with red, itchy, painful skin is no fun. In today's video, we discuss things that contribute to your terrible sunburns. Can exfoliation be one? What about essential oils and anti-aging creams? Are margaritas really connected to sunburns? We'll be talking about all of this and more. Number 1. Exfoliators. So you love your exfoliating regimen? Everybody does. That awesome feeling you get when you scrub the dirt and dead skin off your face is beyond words. But here is the catch. Your exfoliating might be ruining your beach visits. When you exfoliate, you also remove your outermost protective skin layer, the one that guards your skin from sunburns. Exfoliation exposes your soft inner layer of skin, which is far more vulnerable to sun damage. Your skin becomes more sensitive to the sun this way. But it's not just scrubbing. Exfoliation masks, microdermabrasion, and chemical peels all have this effect on the skin. So the right thing would be to step up the sunscreen and apply it several times a day. Make sure you don't overexfoliate. You need to get rid of the dirt and dead cells. Moderation is the key. Number 2, antibiotics. Are you using antibiotics? If yes, here's a word of caution. Antibiotics can make your skin sensitive to the sun. If you're using a prescription, ask your doctor or pharmacist about possible skin-related side effects. Antibiotics prescribed by dermatologists for acne can make your skin sensitive to sunburns. There's another antibiotic given for Lyme disease or severe acne, which also leaves your skin prone to sun damage. Even medicines like Bactrim, which is used to treat bladder infections and bronchitis, make your skin photosensitive. This means your skin is not only prone to sunburns, but it also worsens it. Ouch! Are you finding this list useful so far? Well, this next point will surely surprise you, but before we continue, why not subscribe to our channel for more videos like this, and hit the bell icon so you're always up to date. Number 3, anti-aging cream. We all love our anti-aging creams. They give us glowing, wrinkle-free, and smooth skin. But did you know your anti-aging products are leading you to sunburns? Confused? Here's what happens. Anti-aging products contain an ingredient called retinol. When applied on the skin, retinol increases collagen production and gives you the soft, renewed skin you've always wanted. In fact, retinol is considered to be the gold standard for anti-aging products, but every good thing comes with a challenge. The new skin cells produced by retinol are way more delicate. After all, they are new. And new skin cells should never be directly exposed to the sun. They're at a greater risk of sun damage. So, should you give up your anti-aging creams? Absolutely not! For starters, invest in a high-quality sunscreen that has a higher SPF. You can use retinol creams at night when there's no risk of sun exposure. If you're using a prescription retinol cream, exercise caution a lot more. If there's an option, you can either skip your high-strength retinol cream for the summer or use an over-the-counter one with low retinol strength. Just remember, if you're careless about sunscreen, you have no business using retinol cream. Before we move ahead, here's a video you might like. Want to take extra care of your skin and eat foods that boost collagen production? Here's a video on the 9 best collagen-boosting foods that help you keep your skin looking young and healthy. Number 4, margaritas. Who doesn't love happy hour? Whether you're just hanging out at your friend's place or having a relaxed afternoon, margaritas cheer you up like a long-lost best friend. They have the power to turn the most boring parties awesome. But unfortunately, your margaritas are not kind to your skin. Margaritas with citrus juices, like lime, can trigger a phototoxic reaction. Chemicals in citrus foods activate after being exposed to sunlight and damage your skin. In short, margaritas with lime wedges or orange juice makes your skin photosensitive. You end up with discoloration on your hands and lips. So exercise caution while partying at the beach. Your skin will thank you later. Number 5, SPF in your sunscreen. Do you have your sunscreen? Did you take a look at the SPF level? Not all sunscreens are created equal. Some of us consider the properties of sunscreen while purchasing, and then of course you have waterproof variants. But it's time you prioritize the SPF first. The higher the SPF, the better the protection against harmful UV radiation. For instance, a sunscreen with SPF 15 will protect you against 95% of UVB rays, but when you switch to SPF 30, you'll be shielded from almost 98% of them. You might say that there is hardly any difference between 95 and 98% protection, but in reality, the difference is critical. When heading out, you need to apply a shot glass amount of sunscreen over your entire body. You should also reapply it every 2 to 3 hours. This is why experts recommend you get SPF 30 to 50 to help make up for the lesser amount you apply. Another major problem that leaves you exposed to sun damage is using sunscreen beyond its expiry date. Many of us even forget to take a look at it. Sunscreens past their prime are ineffective. Anyways, if you apply sunscreen the right way and in the right amount, you won't have leftovers. Ideally, you shouldn't have any sunscreen left unused beyond the summer season. Number 6. Clouds. So you thought about stepping out and notice it's a pleasantly cloudy day. That means there's no harsh sun rays, so you can skip on sunscreen. After all, clouds are blocking the sun's rays, right? Wrong! It doesn't matter if it's a cloudy day, you need to apply your sunscreen because its harmful UV rays can penetrate the clouds. They provide us with a false sense of security. In reality, 40% of UV rays are still reaching us. Without applying sunscreen, you've exposed your skin to harmful UV rays for so long it will end up giving you a sunburn. Oops. Number 7. Forgetting to reapply. Stepping out for a fun-filled day? Applied a really good amount of sunscreen to protect you all day long? Perfect, isn't it? Unfortunately, no. When you're exposed to the sun consistently, you cannot depend on your sunscreen to protect you the entire day. You'll have to reapply it every 2 hours, otherwise you're completely on your own. In case you're swimming, apply it immediately before and after. No matter how good your sunscreen is, the water will wash it away. The same goes for sweating. Your sunscreen might say waterproof, yet a lot of it gets washed away after you wipe your sweat off. Set up a timer to remind you every 2 hours, in case you're headed to the beach for a relaxing day. Every time you wipe your face or body, slather sunscreen again. Number 8. Sunscreen spray. Is there anything more irritating than the zigzag tan lines you notice after returning home? Blame your awful sunscreen spray. That's right, I said it. You may think it's convenient to simply spray sunscreen before going out, but the spray makes it very easy to miss a spot, leaving you exposed to sun rays. So the next time you feel lazy and reach for the spray, remind yourself of the zigzag lines. You need to cover every inch of your skin or you're likely to get a sunburn. Number 9. Essential oils. Love essential oils? We all do. Unfortunately, they contribute to sunburns. Certain essential oils, especially the citrus ones like grapefruit oil and lime and lemon, contain compounds that make your skin more sensitive. Avoid sun exposure for the next 12 hours after using it. I know it's tough, but it has to be done. Do you apply sunscreen often? Have you ever had a really bad sunburn? Let us know in the comments below. We would love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie are we if we don't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.